channel Master Mathematics by Shaiji Mohandas. Today we are discussing about the topic matrix. I am going to show this topic as very easy for you after watching the entire video. So you have to make sure that watch the entire video. Okay, this is the all summary about the matrix chapter. We have already discussed about matrix chapter and some of the problem also done in my channel. Those who haven't seen that video, means please do check it out, the playlist matrix. Let us start today's topic, matrix. Before going in depth of the matrix, we have to know about what is mean by a matrix. So matrix means it is a rectangular arrangement. It is a rectangular arrangement of elements. That means rows and columns. Okay. For example of matrix is A is said to be a matrix. A11, A12, A13, etc. A1n. That means this is a horizontal line. This horizontal line is called rows. That means here n rows. Okay. This vertical line A11, A21, AM1, this is called A columns. Okay, this here we have M columns. Okay, so the matrix is M into N. The order of matrix is M into A. Okay, so basically matrix is very simple, nothing but it is a rectangular arrangement of columns and rows. The horizontal line is called the rows. That here the matrix have n rows and here the m columns. Okay, so from that, these included inside the rectangle, these a11, a12, these are called elements of the matrix. So basically the matrix is the rectangular arrangement of m columns and n rows. Okay, so in matrix we have to learn some of the important concepts. Okay, what are they? Here different types of matrix also is there. Equality matrix, operations of matrix, transpose of matrix, symmetric and skew symmetric, and inverse of matrix. These all included in this video. So you have to watch the entire video. Don't skip it. Okay. Then only you will understand the concept. If you once you got an idea about matrix means, it is very easy to do better in your examination. Okay. Let us start. Next one is different types of matrix. Before going to different types of matrix, I will show you one example for matrix here. A is said to be a matrix here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So look at this matrix. This 1, 2 elements, this is called rows. This is called rows. This also a row. That means how many rows I have? This is 2 rows. And this is called column and this is called column. So how many column? 2. So this matrix is said to be 2 into 2 matrix. That means 2 columns and 2 rows. So whatever here written, the here means 3 into 1 means 3 columns and 1 rows. If it is 2 by 2 means 2 columns and 2 rows. Next here 2 into 3 means 2 columns and 3 rows. So M is denoted by column and N is denoted by rows of the matrix. Okay. Next we are moving on to the different types of matrix. Different types of matrix means it has include a column matrix, row matrix, diagonal matrix, identity matrix, zero matrix. Okay. So first one is column matrix. In column matrix, it has only one column. It has only one column. It is called column matrix. For example, A is said to be here A, B, C. So it has consist only one column that we can denote at the order M into 1 into N. 1 into N. That means M columns. Okay. Next, second one is row matrix. So row matrix is nothing but here. The A is said to be row matrix. It will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So let us see this. How many rows are there? 1 rows. That means we can write it as m into 1. That means only 1 row. It have lot of columns. That's not a problem. But here only 1 row. Here also, here 3 rows have but only 1 column. That is called column matrix. And this is called row matrix. Okay. Next, we are moving on to the square matrix. What is mean by a square matrix? The square matrix means if A is said to be square matrix, it is denoted by matrix Aij. Aij. Because what is Aij means? We can denote it M by N. M is the columns and N is the rows. So Aij means I and J are the number of elements. If it is the matrix is in the form A11, A12, A13, etc. Here Aij, that means I is the first element, means I is 1, J is 1. If it is in the second element, in the second column, means this is I is 1 and J is 2. So if you substitute the value of I is 1 and J is 1, means this is the first column, first element. Okay. If it is 2, 1 means second row, first element. Okay. These are the method to represent the matrix A, I, J, M and U. From here, if any of the matrix is said to be A is 1, 2, 3, 4. So look at this matrix. How many rows? 2 rows and 2 columns. That means we can write it as 2 into 2. That means A is said to be a square matrix, means here M is equal to N. Equal number of columns into rows. So equal number of columns and rows are called the square matrix. So this is 2 by 2 matrix. This is a square matrix. For another example, A is equal to A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. So this is also a square matrix because 3 rows and 3 columns, that means 3 by 3. So here M is equal to N. It is called the square matrix. Okay. Next we are moving on to the diagonal matrix. What is mean by a diagonal matrix? The diagonal matrix is nothing but very easy. It is non-diagonal elements are 0 is called diagonal matrix. For example, let us see. This is a rectangle. This is a rectangle. What is the diagonal? Diagonal means this is. The opposite points are joining together is called a diagonal. So in case of matrix, the diagonal matrix is non-diagonal elements are 0 are called diagonal matrix. For example, A is said to be diagonal matrix. Here, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3. Look at this example. A is said to be diagonal matrix means the non-diagonal elements are 0. So the diagonal elements means this is the diagonal elements. But the diagonal elements are 1, 2, 3. But non-diagonal elements, look at this. Non-diagonal elements all are 0. These also 0, these also 0. So this type of matrix is called diagonal matrix. What is mean by a diagonal matrix? The non-diagonal elements are 0. Non-diagonal elements. Non-diagonal elements are 0 is called a diagonal matrix. Okay. If it is here, the diagonal elements are there, but non-diagonal elements are 0 is called the diagonal matrix. Okay. Then what does mean by identity matrix? Which is nothing but very simple. Identity matrix means the diagonal elements are 1. The diagonal elements are 1. And non diagonal elements are 0. For example, A is said to be 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So this is called the identity matrix of 3 by 3. Okay. So in any order they have an identity matrix. Okay. So it is identity matrix means it is very easy and simple. The diagonal elements are 1. and non-diagonal elements are 0. It's called identity matrix. This is the 3x3 identity matrix. Next, A is said to be 1001 means it is 2x2 matrix. That is 2x2 identity matrix. Okay. So, what is mean by a order of matrix? Order of matrix means it is easy and nothing but. Order of matrix means a matrix is said to be 1, 2, 3, 4. The order is said to be 2x2. This is called the order of matrix. For example, another example, A is said to be a matrix A, B, C, D, E, F, which is nothing but here, what is the order? 1 column, 2 column, 3 column. So, 3x2 matrix is the order of matrix. That means, how many number of columns and rows are there? That is called the order of matrix. M into N. That is the order of matrix. Okay? Next, last one is the zero of matrix. What is zero of matrix? The all elements of matrix is 0 is to be 0 matrix, which is nothing but very easy. A is said to be 0 matrix, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. All elements to the matrix is 0, that is 0 by 3x3 matrix is 0 matrix. Okay, so these are the different types of matrix. Next, we are moving on to equality of two matrix. Equality of two matrix is said to be if A and B are two matrix, A and B are two matrix. A is said to be, we can write it as the matrix Aij and M into N, and B is said to be Bij, M into N. If the two matrix are equal, means the number of elements of matrix A is equal to the number of elements of B. That means here Aij into M into N equal to Bij, M into N. These are called equality of matrix. If any two matrix is to be equal, that means the number of elements in the A matrix is equal to number of elements in the B matrix. It is said to be equality of a matrix. For example, A is said to be 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is said to be 1, 2 and 3, 4. So, this is 2x2 matrix. This is also 2x2 matrix. The all elements are equal. That's elements of A is equal to elements of B. So, elements of A equal to elements of B. These are called A is equal to B. So, these are called equality of A matrix. So, the elements of A is equal to the elements of B is called the equality of A matrix. So, these three are we completed. Next, we are moving on to operations of matrix. There is a lots of operation included in this matrix. Addition, subtraction, multiplication. Everything I done in my channel with the examples and problems, textbook, exercises, everything is done in my channel. Those who haven't seen that video, miss, please check it out, that playlist matrix. Okay. Next, transpose of a matrix. What does mean by a transpose of a matrix? Transpose of a matrix is nothing but if A is said to be a matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a square matrix 2x2. What is the transpose of this matrix? Which is nothing but the transpose is denoted by A transpose or A dash. If A transpose is denoted by A, T or A dash. What is mean by a transpose mean? It is the column changes into rows and the rows changes into column. Which is nothing but here, A is the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 means what is A transpose? That is 1, 3, 2, 4. Look at this matrix. The column changes into rows and rows changes into column. So, it is generally we can say the transpose of matrix means the columns changes into rows and rows changes into column. This is called the transpose of a matrix. Okay. Based on the transpose, lots of applications are coming here. It is based on symmetric and skew symmetric. Everything included based on the transpose method. You have to write the transpose of A means it is very easy. The column changes into rows and and rows changes into column. For another example, A is said to be 1, 4, 6, 5. This is a square matrix 2 by 2. What is a transpose? A transpose is equal to this column changes into rows means 1, 6, and this column 4, 5. So this is the transpose of a matrix. It is very easy and simple. Okay. Next, we are moving on to the symmetric and skew symmetric. Symmetric and skew symmetric matrix is, it is very easy and nothing but related to transpose matrix. If A is said to be a matrix, a square matrix, and the A transpose is also another matrix. If A is said to be symmetric means, here A equal to A transpose. That means A and A transpose are equal matrix. That means the number of elements in A is equal to number of elements in A transpose. This is called symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix. Okay. So symmetric matrix means A is said to be a matrix and you have to write the A transpose. If A is said to be symmetric means the number of elements of A is equal to the number of elements of A transpose. That means if these two are equal means it is called a symmetric matrix. Then what is meant by a skew symmetric? Which also simple and nothing but A is said to be skew symmetric means A equal to minus A transpose, or otherwise A transpose is equal to minus A. This is called a skew symmetric matrix. Okay. So the skew symmetric matrix is nothing but the skew means you have to put a minus based on A and A transpose. So if it is A is said to be a skew symmetric matrix means A equal to minus A transpose. Otherwise, A transpose is equal to minus A. Okay. Next, the last one is the inverse of A matrix. What is mean by A? Inverse of A matrix means if A and B are two matrix, AB equal to BA equal to I. What is mean by I? I means identity matrix. What is mean by identity matrix? I. So AB, A into B equal to B into A equal to I. Whatever it may be, AB equal to I means it is said to be A is the inverse of B. A is the inverse of B. Otherwise, B is the inverse of A. These are the two conditions. If the product of two matrices is, we will get the answer is identity matrix means we can say A is the inverse of B, otherwise B is the inverse of A. These are the condition about inverse of A matrix. If A is said to be an inverse matrix, you have to multiply two matrix. We will get the identity matrix means it is very easy to say A is the inverse of B. So these are the important topics included in your matrix chapter. These all concepts are very, very important in your board examination. Once you understand these all concepts means it is easy to find the solution and you have to get maximum marks in this chapter. In this matrix chapter, you can score 14 marks. So you have to thoroughly go through this concept. First of all, you have to understand the concept. After that, you have to do the problem. That is better way to study. Okay. So I hope you all understood these all concepts. If you have any suggestion, please write on the comment box. Okay. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if it is useful in this video, means you have to do share into your friends. Okay. And those who haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe and hit all button from my channel. Then only you will get more notification from my channel. Okay. Next video is based on the important problems and previously asked question from the matrix chapter. So keep watching on my channel. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon on my next video. Until then, bye.